In the 20th century, human energy focused on economic development and technological progress as we struggled for more wealth. But times have changed. People are beginning to realize the extent of what they are losing in exchange for development. In particular, the rapid deterioration of the global environment is casting a dark shadow over our future. Voyage to the Future is co-produced by broadcasters representing 8 Asian countries. The aim is to take a close look at the global environment. Voyage to the Future also explores the role that television can play in raising the awareness of young people facing a challenging future. Voyage to the Future starts with a program made in Japan. Asia has a rich variety of terrain, climates and cultures. Now the children of Asia can study their environment together through the medium of television. In a special lesson held at a TV studio in Tokyo, these young people will learn more about the global environment. Their teacher is Lester Brown, an expert on environmental issues. For over 40 years, he has observed environmental change and taken every opportunity to warn people of the crisis facing the Earth. It's time for the lesson to begin.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm Les Brown, and today I'm going to be your teacher. How many of you are nervous? Now, we're going to ask each of you to bring your flags down and place it on your country. And we'll do that one at a time. Masa, do you want to lead? It should be easy for you. Were you born in Tokyo?
Yes, I was born in Tokyo and I lived in New York for like 8 years.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
That's why you speak English so
yes.
Well.
Yeah.
Great. Masa, thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Ayaka?
Ayaka grew up in Singapore, a small island nation.
You covered up the whole country, didn't you?
Yeah, well, it's a small country. But it's the best
country. Okay.
Attending Lester's special class are 16 Asian junior high school students living in Japan. They represent 9 countries, including India, Malaysia, China, and South Korea.
To give you a bit of background on who I am, aside from being an American, we have a few photographs. Can you see what's in those baskets?
Potatoes.
Tomatoes. Yes. I started life on a small farm in southern New Jersey, and in high school and college, my brother and I started our own farming operation. We bought an old tractor, $200, overhauled it, got it running, rented a couple fields from a farmer who had retired, and then sort of kept expanding the operation through high school and college.
Lester first went overseas when he was 22. He stayed in 3 Indian villages and got his first experience of cultural exchange.
These are my host sisters teaching me how to count in Hindi, for example. Ek, do, teen, cha, punch. Am I okay so far? Okay. So anyhow, they had great fun trying to teach me a bit of Hindi and also teaching me to count.
Lester even had a chance to try wrestling. But apart from having fun, India brought him face to face with extreme poverty and starvation. Lester had intended to take up farm management as his life's work, but on his return from India, he went to work for the Department of Agriculture. He wanted to address the world's food problems. Lester made his mark in 1965 when he alone predicted a famine in India.
We don't have a textbook for this class. In lieu of that, we're going to be looking at environmental headlines, all in Asia, various environmental events in Asia, from probably something from just about every country that you represent. And we're looking at 10 environmental headlines in Asia during the 10-year period. We'll look at them, and then we're going to ask you to vote on which issues you think are the most important. Can we go with the headlines?
As teaching material, Lester has selected 10 news topics that appear to be unrelated. He wants his students to think about what they regard as important in Asia's environment. The Chinese capital, hit by maybe the biggest dust storm in 10 years. Himalayan glaciers are melting. Is this because of global warming? Asia's energy situation is changing, and the continent faces new challenges. Throughout Afghanistan, drought has left the land scorched and dry. Food is scarce. Big city garbage. In the Philippines, a mountain of trash collapsed and killed more than 200 people. The population of India is now 1 billion and rising. The Yangtze River in China overflows, causing the worst flood in half a century. Species introduced from other countries threaten local ecosystems. Massive fires destroy the tropical rainforests of Indonesia. Because of cold weather, Japan has its worst rice harvest in post-war history, prompting emergency imports.
We're going to have a chance to vote now on which of the environmental disasters, the environmental headlines that we saw over the last 10 years in Asia, are the most important. And each of you gets two votes, and you vote by picking up two balls and dropping them in whichever issue you think is the most serious. Okay, shall we start with the front row, Masa? Now you get a chance to say, do I agree or don't I agree with Masa?
What will the students choose from among the 10 news topics? Environmental challenges have no borders. These young people are not simply concerned about problems in their own country. Now let's look at the news items, starting with the one that got the least votes. Number 10.
In 1993, Japan experienced unusual weather. Powerful typhoons and heavy rain caused serious damage. Many regions had their worst crop failure on record. In some places, the rice yield was less than a third that of an average year. The government responded with large-scale emergency rice imports from various countries. The shortage of rice caused its international price to go up from 240 to 500 US dollars per ton in just a few months. For many rice-importing nations, this price was hard to bear.
Now straight to number 8. Two items shared this spot.
In the summer of 1998, the Yangtze River in China broke its banks, causing record floods. 4,000 people died, and for several months the waterlogged land prevented 5 million others from going home. 100,000 troops were sent in, but even these were scarcely enough. The water went above the danger level and just kept rising. The flooding caused losses estimated at $31 billion.
Number 7.
From time to time, huge dust storms occur in inland China, seriously affecting people's everyday lives. With the wind gusting at over 120 kilometers per hour, a dust storm in 1993 caused unprecedented damage, killing 116 people and 120,000 farm animals. In 2002, the most powerful dust storm in 10 years hit Beijing. Dust storms are spawned in Mongolia and the Chinese interior, where the wind lifts desert sand into the air. On this occasion, visibility was reduced to 50 meters, and the storm deposited 20 tons of dust per square kilometer. The next day, the storm spread to South Korea. The storm raised the density of dust in the air 24 times higher than normal. Hospitals were packed with people complaining of sore throats and eye irritation. More than 1,600 kindergartens and elementary schools were shut down. Many domestic flights were cancelled. The economy suffered badly. In recent years, these dust storms have travelled beyond Korea and Japan and have even been observed in North America. Awareness of the problem is spreading.